Hello, this is Bern, and if you're with a man who needs to make a massive shift in his life and he isn't doing it, perhaps he's an alcoholic and needs to stop drinking, maybe he's addicted to drugs, maybe he's someone who is very abusive verbally or emotionally, maybe he's a guy who hates his career with all his passion and is making your life miserable and my life miserable of everybody around him, but he's unwilling to change it, I'm going to share with you on this episode why sticking by him is not only the most painful and destructive thing you could do for yourself, but also the most unloving thing you could do for him. So stick with me. Hello, this is Vern. Welcome to your greatlifetobe.com, a space where I share with ambitious, heart-centered, conscious and driven women how you can create the relationship of your dreams with no gimmicks, no manipulations, no crazy funky techniques, but as a result of stepping into the most alive, the most conscious and the most feminine version of yourself. Today's topic is pretty heavy and it's called Stop Trying to Save Him. Why? Because so many of you beautiful, amazing, intelligent women feel in your heart of hearts that you could actually save the man you're with. Sometimes you feel like you love someone so much and that's the reason why you're with him despite his big flaw, and that big flaw is something that's self-destructive or destructive to people around him, including you. And I'm going to start by telling you that there's a false narrative that plays into the minds and hearts of women who can't leave a man who needs to make a massive change, but it's not making that change. And that is the narrative that you're with him because you love him so much. And here's what I'm going to share with you. Loving someone, a high level, conscious way of loving someone is doing not what is best for you, but what is best for them. And if by virtue of you being with this man, you sticking by him, you're enabling behavior that is destructive to him, to his family, and to you, then being with him is not just incredibly unloving, but it's incredibly selfish on your part. Now, before you get all pissed off and start throwing tomatoes at the screen, I want you to listen to me. There's three different things that love is not, and I want to make sure that you fully understand the mix of emotions here beyond just love. Attachment is not love. Attachment is where you feel this overwhelming need to be with someone, and in part because that's filling a void in your life, because that's allowing you to not think of other things, because that's meeting some of your needs, and sometimes in unhealthy ways. So attachment, feeling like you can't live without someone, is not love, it's simply attachment. Addiction isn't love. When something is bad for you and you stick by it, be it a substance or a human being, that is not love. That is self-hatred at best, and hatred towards the other person as an extension of it. Why? Because it creates a lot of intensity, but it also creates a lot of pain, so it's unsustainable. So attachment's not love, addiction's not love, and enabling shitty, fucked up behavior, sweet person, isn't love. When you show someone that the behavior they are stepping into is acceptable to the world, that it's something that's okay, there's no consequence to the actions that he's partaking in, then you are simply enabling that addiction, that painful behavior on his part to magnify. And that is in love. So I want you to ask yourself a question. If you find yourself with someone who has something massive, something big, I'm not talking about a specific flaw, we all have flaws, a massive flaw that's self-destructing and that can potentially destroy you, your emotions, your self-esteem, and you're not able to break apart from him, I want you to imagine a little circle, right? And in this circle, there is love, which I can't deny that there's some level of love in you and this guy, but it's not the whole circle. I want you to tell yourself the truth and at least in principle say what percentage of the whole thing is love, what percentage is attachment, what percentage is addiction, what percentage is enabling. And if the proportions are pretty even, then it's not a good situation for you. Now, I want you to ask yourself this question because I wish I had like a black and white rule I could give you that says, well, if he's doing these three things right now, absolutely, he's not good for you. I'm not going to do that right now, but what I will do is I'll give you a principle. And the principle is, if you being with him is damaging your life, it's damaging your self-esteem, it's damaging your mental health, That is a situation where you want to extricate yourself from the relationship and allow him the space that he needs to heal, to get help, to focus on him exclusively versus you and him. He doesn't have the energy. He doesn't have the focus. No matter what, he says to focus on both of you. He's going through a life-changing, life-altering, painful situation like an addiction. So a couple of the reasons why I find women don't leave a situation like this is because they tell themselves lies. And the lie would be like, he doesn't have anyone. I'm not saying that it's a lie in the sense that maybe he doesn't have anyone, but instead of telling yourself he doesn't have anyone, what if you tell yourself, I am enabling him not having anyone, because if I remove myself from the situation, there will be no other option but for him to make his fucking life work. There's no other option but for him to reach out to more human beings, to create a life of more meaning, to create a life of more service, to create a life where there's a bigger tribe that doesn't rely on just one human being. Instead of telling yourself, no one can help him but me, tell yourself, your help is not helping. If your help were helping, he would be out of the situation right now. So perhaps allowing a professional to help him apart from this relationship is the kindest thing you can do to him. I take you back to the premise I shared with you at the beginning of this video, which is love takes many different forms. If your definition of love is holding somebody tight and patting them in the ass, and that's the extent of the lack of depth of your definition, then you will never leave him. But if in your definition of love is, I'm going to do the thing that may hurt me in the short term, but it's the best thing for him long term, then loving him is leaving him many times. I'll give you one last analogy. You make sure you understand this. Sometimes somebody's drowning and you're going to have a life jacket that you're going to throw at this human being. Now, when you throw the life jacket to a human being and you can, with your strength and your awareness, pull this human being out, well, you saved that person. But when you throw the life jacket and you feel the gravitational pull of a black hole pushing you into the water and drowning you, that's a situation where you have to let go of life jacket and allow life, another human being, this person's family, or the grace of God or the universe to help him out without you terminating your life in the process. I'm very passionate about this subject because I connect with so many women who feel like they really can't save a man, and you cannot save a man. Many times, removing yourself from the situation is the best thing you can do, because then he's faced with the reality of not only losing you, but focusing on himself and getting real help of the kind that needs a lot of focus and no distractions, including the relationship. Hope this is helpful, useful, insightful, you, my dear. If it is, I'm going to ask you to do three things. Thing number one, please click like on this video or thumbs up. Thing number two, subscribe to my channel. And if you want to be notified of new episodes, hit the little bell so that they show up in your feed. Thing number three, if you want to learn how to create a powerful relationship with a lot less pain than your current trajectory, there's two options. Option number one is on the first line of the description of this video, you'll find a link that all you have to do is click on the link, enter name and email, and be taken to a free presentation, a free masterclass that I created for you that will show you how to start stepping into that kind of relationship. If you're listening to this right now and saying, Bern, I love the videos, but for fuck's sakes, I need real help. I need the help of hand-holding, I need accountability, I need strategy, and I need someone to show me the way of leaving a relationship that's not good for me or entering a healthy one. Can you do that? Well, funny you should ask. There's another link on the description of this video that will share with you an application. You can submit an application. If I feel I can help you, my assistant will reach out and schedule a time with you. If I feel I can help you, then no harm done. We'll let you know as well. Thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you to live a full and conscious life.